गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
Okay, so good morning, everyone. So it seems that everyone is in holiday mood. No one has joined so far. Is the previous class still going on?
Sir, in the previous class, sir gave us a in-class exercise, so it will go on till 11:05, so they will join after that.
Okay. So what we should do then? Okay, so how you guys are doing?
So fine.
Okay, and where have you based?
Sir, I am currently in Delhi.
So you are in Delhi itself. Okay. Okay, so how are you doing, Aditya and Keith?
Fine, sir.
Okay, great, great. So I believe you have completed your in-class exercise, right?
Yes, I just submitted.
Okay. Is it graded one?
So the weightage is less, but yes, it is graded.
Okay. Okay. So I believe the instructor is Raghav, right?
Yes, sir. Raghav, sir.
Okay, great. Okay, so Ashwin, how are you doing? Abhay, how are you?
Fine, sir. I'm good. How are you?
Yeah, I'm good too. Hey, Tajdeep.
सर आपसे एक बात पूछनी थी सर सर क्विज में पार्शियल मार्किंग पॉसिबल होगी क्या सर क्योंकि वो
नहीं है वो पॉसिबल नहीं है
नहीं है
सो बिकॉज़ दैट इज फेयर फर्स्टली इट इज फेयर फॉर एवरीवन अगर इट हैज बीन द इन क्लास आई मीन ऑफलाइन क्लासेस तो डेफिनेटली आई शुड हैव कंसीडर बट व्हाटएवर हैपेंड इन मिड सेम हैज शॉक्ड मी एंड दैट हैज बेसिकली फोर्स्ड मी टू डू सो तो सॉरी आई कैन नॉट डू एनीथिंग
ये
बात कर रहे थे आयुष नहीं आया अभी तक Okay, guys, so I think we can get started.
And so actually, there's in class in the previous class, that's why there'll be a bit of delay and people coming.
Koi nahi, baki log baad mein join kar lenge. You guys can tell them.
Okay.
So I hope you can see my screen, right? Can you see my screen?
No, sir.
No?
No, sir.
Can you see it now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, great. So in the last class, we started design, prototyping, and construction. And we have discussed the different part of it. So for example, we have discussed, like we discussed about prototyping. We discussed about briefly about conceptual design, concrete design, how you can use scenarios, generating prototype, construction. So we have discussed about low fidelity and high fidelity prototype. And we have also discussed that while designing the prototype, we do some kind of compromises, right? Because sometimes it is not possible for you to probably replicate or probably do everything in the prototype. So that's why you do some kind of compromises, sometimes in requirements, sometimes in features, and so on. So regarding conceptual design, as we discussed in the last class, so a conceptual design is an outline of what people can do with the product and what concepts are needed to understand and interact with them. So it's more about conceptually you explain the basically the product to the users. Okay, so what are the features you are going to look at? What are the problem? What are the functionality you are going to have? So in order to understand these functionality, what are the concepts you need to understand? So for example, what is the prerequisite of using anything? If anything prerequisite is required, then you need to understand and probably make the appropriate action for that. And it's basically, you also need to understand and interact with it. So whatever the required concept, you need to explain. So for example, if it is about withdrawing money, then the person need to aware of how to withdraw money. What are the actions will be there in case to withdraw money? What are the things they need to carry in order to withdraw the money, and so on, right? Accordingly, you can make the required changes, because while using the conceptual model, you can also get to understand, okay, so what are the requirements you need to understand? What are the current requirement and what you need to basically emphasize? And also you need to empathize with user, what are the capability they have? So if you recall in the previous class, we discussed about an old age person, basically he want to run, you want to help with the person. So how you can basically support such person by building something, right? So conceptual modeling basically help in creativity and brainstorming the technique, because once you know, okay, so what are the different concepts you are going to have? What are the different functionality you are going to have? You can basically discuss with them. You can basically brainstorm. Okay, so what are the techniques now can be further used in order to solve them? So consider that it basically also help you to consider different alternatives based on the scenarios and the scenarios and the prototype. You can basically evaluate different possible alternative, and accordingly you can take appropriate action. So in the last class, we also discussed about choosing an interface metaphor. We have also discussed in previous as well as the earlier classes, what are the benefits of metaphor? Metaphor is basically kind of the way you try to build some analogy, where basically you can create interface metaphor to combine the familiar knowledge that you have with the new knowledge in a way to basically get some basically work done. So basically it helps user to understand the product, how the different component will work. So for example, if we're talking about withdrawing the money, so it should be the similar concept that you have withdrawing from something. So for example, withdrawing from the bank account that you do in the in physical mode by going to the probably the bank branch and probably filling the form and something. Similar thing probably if you want to achieve through the online withdrawing money, probably transferring money. So similar thing can be done by using the similar analogy that you apply in other scenarios. So it involves basically three steps. So first is understand the functionality, what functionality you are willing to provide to the user. Identify potential problem area, because once you understand the different functionality, you will realize, okay, even based on the interaction with the user as well. So what are the potential areas where probably the user may face issue? What are the potential problem you need to solve? And once you identify that, you can basically name them. We can basically generate the meta for that. Okay, so for example, one of the potential problem in the probably withdrawing money is like adding before sending money, you want to add the account, add pay. So in that case, you can generate the metaphor like add pay, something like that. Right? And once the metaphor is ready, you need to evaluate them. So how much structure does it provide? How much relevant is to the problem? For example, if the metaphor that you are using for adding some pay, so it should be name according. If you are withdrawing something money, then it should be the metaphor should be used for that is like withdraw or something like that. And is it easy to represent? Is it easy to understand? Whether the odd, is it the common term or some very complex term? So for example, if you recall one of the, in the earlier classes, we have discussed about a book, right? So Amir Khan explained what the book is in very, very complex term, right? So you need to create an interface. You need to basically use the interface metaphor accordingly, so that it is easily understandable by the audience. And finally, how extensible it is, because you also need to think about scalability. You also need to think about extensibility, about the feature, about the overall components that you have for the prototype. So once you have the interface, right? Once you're basically providing the different feature, there are two things you need to consider in mind. So first is the interaction type. So how you are going to facilitate the interaction between the user of your system and probably your system that you have. So there are several ways you can basically interact. So one interface could be instructing. You can instruct basically the system that you have to do something. Similarly, you can basically do the conversation. You can do the manipulation, exploring and responding. So we have also discussed this interaction type and all these things in more very great details in the many earlier classes, some of the earlier classes, like how the instruction will work, how the conversation will work. Can anybody give me the example of instructing?
Sir, voice over in smartphones, like voice over features, assistive mode.
Okay, very nice. Manipulating. Manipulating.
Sir, playing games.
Sorry, Amit, could you repeat?
Playing games.
Okay. Conversing. I think it's clear, exploring and responding. So anyways, I mean, yeah, we discussed, so manipulating could also be like we delete the object. So while playing, you basically play and probably do something, right? Similarly, apart from interaction type, you need to consider the interface type, right? Whether the interface is like shareable, whether it's like augmented reality based, or is it real, or is it tangible, accordingly, right? So because the interaction and interface types will basically help you providing the functionality in efficient and effective way for the user, the client of your product. So how we can expand the initial conceptual model that we have discussed. So like what functions will be the product will be performing. So if you recall, the first thing we want to understand the functionality, right? So what will the product do and what will the human do? So for example, when as part of the interaction, as part of the functionality, the input need to be provided by the human, right? And once the input the product receives, it will act accordingly. It will do some background processing and accordingly it will return. So for example, in this case of Alexa, right? So Alexa, in case of Alexa, you want to have something, you want to ask something, you need to utter the speech for that. So for example, you utter some sound to the Alexa, like what is the date today? Alexa, what is the date today? So accordingly, so that speech will be, as I said earlier, it will be converted to firstly text, and after converting to text, it will do the processing to understand your query. And based on that query, it will get the answer again. So that answer will be in the text form. And as the next step, that text will be converted to the speech. So the overall, this pipeline in this feature, some part has been done by the human, some part has been done by the product. So that is the clarity you need to have in the conceptual model that you are going to do.
Can you explain the last point?
Which one? This one?
Yeah.
So here what I'm saying, in case of any product, right? So there are two stakeholders, for example. So one is the product, one is the user. How the user will give any instruction, not instruction, how the user will give any command to the, or how basically the user will tell the product to do something, right? So in that case, he need to basically issue some commands, right? So that commands could be in terms of instruction, that could be part of conversation, or even you can issue some command by manipulating the environment, right? So for example, as someone has mentioned about the gaming, right? So through the gaming, you change the environment you play and accordingly you proceed with. So it depends on what you want to achieve. So interaction type is more about how basically you give some message to the product a system to do something for you, right? Interface type is basically how you can achieve the interaction between the user and interaction between the user and probably the product, right? So in that case, there should be some interface through which it can give the message. So one is, it could be shareable, right? It could be augmented reality, it could be tangible, and so forth, right? So interface type is directly and the interface through which the user can interact with the product. And what are the different interaction could be, type could be. So it could be through instruction, it could be conversing, manipulating, and so on. Is it clear now?
Yes, sir.
Okay, great. So expanding the initial conceptual model, which we are saying, so we discuss about like what the product will do, what the human do. So it's more about understanding the problem space, what functionality you want to achieve. And so once you have the functionality, you need to think of, okay, so what functionality you need to provide in the sequential basis, what functionality you can provide on parallel basis, right? Similarly, you need to do some categorization, like for example, all actions related to privacy on a smartphone. So anything related to the privacy, you need to probably keep it aside, or probably anything related to say about experience, you can keep it aside. You can basically categorize them. And once you are able to categorize them, you can focus on them later on. So for example, the team which is focusing on the interface will keep track of anything related with interface, and accordingly they will solve them, right? So sometimes the functionality, as I mentioned, it could be solved in parallel, it could be in sequential. It depends on whether they when can anybody tell me when we need to do the sequential and when it is we need to do the parallel functionality. Can anyone give the example, like in what cases we need to perform the sequential actions and in what cases we can perform the parallel actions?
The sequential action can be filling the form.
Right. So because you cannot go to the next page until probably you provide first your roll number or something like that. So for example, you cannot access the form until you create your login, right? Until you log in and so on, right?
Yes. So parallel action.
Parallel for multitasking.
So for example, it could be your system will also play a music. For example, you're playing a game, right? It also plays a music as well as let you play the game and probably proceed, right? So what information is needed? So what data is needed to perform the task? So that is something you need to have in initial conceptual modeling. And how is the data to be transformed by the system? So how it is going to, firstly, what data it need, and secondly, how this data is going to transform and be used by the system in order to provide the expected output. So the next step after the conceptual design is the concrete design. So if I just ask you by the name itself, what is the difference between concept and the probably conceptual design as well as the concrete design? Anyone? Just based on the meaning of both, conceptual or probably the concrete.
Sir, conceptual design is like a rough idea of what we are going to make, and concrete design is when we have finalized the idea and we are implementing it.
So maybe conceptual design is more about functionality, and concrete design has to take in more than just functionality, that is like aesthetics and other ways in which it's more accessible or usable.
Conceptual design just gives an idea of what we have to make.
Very nice. So in a sense, yeah, you can say that so conceptual design is more on the abstract level, right? And concrete design is more, something you need to, you can go beyond the idea. You need to go beyond the abstraction. Kind of, you need to show something as well, which probably user can try, can see. So that's why, as rightly mentioned, the aesthetics are important. You need to touch and probably feel as well if required, right? So many aspects to concrete design, like it could be in form of color, icons, button, interaction, devices, and so on. So it also about inclusiveness, like what input and output modes now you're going to have. So for example, what are all kind of user is going to have? It could be in terms of like web content accessibility guidelines. So what are the guidelines you are going to follow? So earlier, I mean, you mentioned you'll follow the standard guideline, right? In the conceptual design. But what those guidelines you are going to follow? So in case of concrete design, here you need to write concretely, right? You need to write specifically, okay, so we are going to follow these steps 1, 2, 3, 4 in the guidelines and right. By the way, why do we need to follow the guidelines anyway?
Just standard.
Sir, because guidelines are instructed in some way according to the function. So if you do not follow guidelines, then the product may give an unexpected result.
Okay. Could you please give me a minute? I have a call. Just. Yeah, so sorry about that. So, okay, so yeah. So why do we need guidelines? Yeah.
So to maintain standardization of the protocols or the design aesthetics to be followed. Like, for example, if a company has multiple applications, in order to make a smooth experience, they must follow certain standardizations across the platforms they provide, like Adobe Suite.
Yeah, so because human as a nature, we are very subjective, right? And when the subjectivity comes, what happens? Probably the bias will come, probably the error will come. And so that's why probably we need the standardization, right? So that's why, I mean, based on a lot of research and everything, the people write some guidelines, okay? So yeah, you need to follow these steps. You need to complete these things before you, for example, launch your product to the public user. So for example, what do you think? I mean, suppose I have to launch a speech-based speech assistant to the like product to users, to the public community. What are the guidelines you need to probably follow?
Sir, the speech rate, like the conversation at which the device is speaking to the other person might not be very fast. It should be clear and distinct.
Okay.
It should not depend on the hardware of the person. Like certain accents don't come well with certain speakers. So we need to choose such a accent or that voice should be such that it works well with most of the majority of the speakers available in the smartphone, irrespective of the device.
Hmm. Yeah, very nice.
And also, sir, it should be like its algorithm should be such that if somebody misspells a word or if their accent is not that good, like, for example, certain accents in Asia are not well recognized by Alexa and Google Chrome. So I think those kind of features should be must so that the meaning of what the person is trying to say is apparent to the device.
Yeah, nice, Pakesh. Similarly, I mean, you also need to consider the cross-culture design. So definitely, and the language, as you mentioned, right? So probably the way an American will speak will very, very fast or something, right? But in case of, for example, if Alexa has to speak to an Indian, probably normal user, if she is speaking very fast English, I mean, it will be difficult for us to understand, especially those who don't have very good English. And also, I mean, how about there are many people who don't understand the language? Culturally, I mean, you need to probably provide the services in a way that the local people are probably the, whatever the, your users are there in other countries should be able to probably understand what you are saying. The similar thing, I mean, can be done for other perspective as well, regarding colors, regarding icons. So for example, some locality probably some like different colors, some people probably like some different kind of icons and so on. Yeah, so the next step is generating prototypes. Yeah, so how you can generate the prototype. So before generating the prototype, you need to basically generate a storyboard from the scenario. So if you recall, the scenario is, under what condition, what are all the steps you are going to have in order to achieve something. So you need to basically break down the scenario into different small steps, right? So once you have the small steps, in that case, you're going to create a scene for each small step. So what do you think? How small the steps should be? Or how many steps we need to consider in a scenario? Anyone?
Sir, I didn't get the meaning of scenario here.
Okay, so scenario, you just think of, for example, scenario is the Alexa need to work in house for Indian native or probably Hindi speaking user. So it's more about how you are in what environment and how the system is going to work for a given task. So for example, the task is you need to basically get your booking done. You need to get your booking done through Alexa in Indian, for Indian probably user in say house setting, something like that.
Sir?
Mm-hmm.
Sir, like one example can be, sir, like in quick payments nowadays, there is such feature like for earlier people were more inclined towards instant payment without verification. But now, even after you click on instant payment option, it asks you for the final confirmation before making it. So that can be a scenario in which we want to make a payment and the steps are two. First is that clicking of that button and second right. Verification.
Right. And you can basically further split these steps into smaller steps, because sometimes the task is, as you rightly said, right, done the payment and confirmation. But again, payment involves a number of other small steps, right? So for example, entering the card details, right? Probably entering the OTP, something like that, right? So in a way, you need to break down the scenario into small steps in such a way that you can probably draw a sketch for different small steps. I will show you with an example. I think in that case, it will be more clear. So sketching out a storyboard prompt designer, it basically prompts designer to think about the design issues, because once you basically, you can think of your whole scenario or the whole task, you divide it into small steps. So now the designer know what at, so for example, we have given an option like first you do the transaction, and then secondly the confirmation, right? Payment and then probably the confirmation. So in that case, once we split the payment part, so as I said, it may involve small steps. So for example, it could be entering card details. It could be probably entering OTP and so on. So once we set up different steps, so we know, which part for which step you need to do what, and probably which step probably requires more efforts, right? So for example, for entering card details, we don't want to add all numbers. Probably we just don't want to add probably the number which we need to write so that we don't reveal our all details, right? So for example, often when you enter CVV, it never shows you, right? Have you seen that? Right? So because it basically, even for example, you're writing any password, while logging, it don't show the password usually, right? It just probably dot 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 or probably something. It's kind of encrypted so that while you're writing your password, nobody can see that, right? So what all the different steps which are there when you divide into small steps, that is, it prompts basically the designer to think about, okay, so what are the issues, what could be design issue, what could be functionality issues, and so. And once you done with this. The different steps and probably the storyboards, you can basically generate a card-based prototype from a storyboard, like one basically card for different story that you have. And then you can show it to users, so how interaction is going to happen and basically what will happen in different steps while the system will use the user will use the system. So let me show one example. Here basically you can see here, so the Thomas family gather around Claire joins remotely. So one person joined remotely and the rest of the people is there, right? So will tell their initial idea. Okay, so they are telling something. Then system suggests not here. Then system probably suggests something. And then system shows the description. Then probably the system, okay, so if whatever the suggestion you had, so it probably provide more description about it. So we'll ask for details. So Flotilla confirmed it. Okay, so these are the thing. And once basically you have the details, you can send the confirmation. So in a way, it is just a rough sketch for some part of it. So for example, here basically a list of the, I mean, some booking you want to achieve. And once everything is confirmed, booking is done, you can send the final confirmation email. So when you basically create such a dashboard storyboard, you know, I mean, so for example, for sending email, you need all those details. For sending email, you need to probably, you need to require the following technical skills and accordingly. Similarly, for confirmation, you need to do all those stuff. So for example, you can visualize this as like you are getting OTP, you are doing the confirmation. Once the payment is confirmed, then probably you can send the invoice to the person. So this is another card-based prototype for that. So like, where do you want to go, right? So you can probably just card-based, this is basically indicating, okay, so you can select down from drop-down option. So again, from destination, you want to select, so my passport was issued in which country, you can select that nationality. And then where are you going there? Why are you going there? Whether it's a tourism business or passing, you can select it and the purpose of my trip and so on. So it's more about you can generate the card-based prototype just to let the user play with the system. Okay, so if I choose this, then probably I select some country. And accordingly, once the country is selected, then probably the next thing is it will be prompt to ask like, okay, so what my passport was issued in and which country and so on. And once you provide all those details, and then probably another card would be, okay, so your booking is confirmed, something like that. So in a way, we are doing everything for the user experience, enriching the user experience. And in order to increase the user experience, in order to make the overall user experience good, we need to use the personas, right? Persona is like different type of people you're interacting with. So for example, can anybody give the example of persona? You might have probably covered in your tutorial as well, right? Anyone?
So like design, like persona in general, I don't think card based, I think we tried in our prototyping.
Mm-hmm.
and sticky notes, yes, we tried sticky notes because in order to develop frames for the Lookify design, but like visual representation only was what was followed mainly on whiteboards, designing frames, I think.
Sir, I think the previous Windows used to have that paperclip that used to give responses. Mm-hmm. I guess that would be a persona of sorts.
Okay. So persona is more about like, so for example, what all type of user going to use your system. So for example, one type of user would be say educated people. One type of people would be probably say illiterate people. One type of user could be probably say from rural areas and so on. So depends. So because for different type of people, the probably the knowledge which they require or probably the information they require, because probably for the person, who cannot write, right? In that case, you need to provide the interface of say speaking, right? Rather than writing, I mean, the option he has is to speak, right? And then probably you need to convert that speak through text. Similarly, probably the person who's from, some Hindi speaking region, right? In that case, you need to provide, you cannot provide an option in Gujarati, Bengal, and so on, right? Accordingly, you need. So it's more about the different type of people have different capabilities and they have their limitations. Accordingly, you need to provide the functions, right? Okay, so visual representation, visual, you also need to show the visual representation of how to improve the overall user experience. So that is can be done through user map, design map, customer or user journey throughout the scenario that you're talking about. And from finally the experience map. So there are two common visual representation that we have. One is called wheel, another is called timeline. Let's see some example for that. So this is the example of, yes.
Sir, in persona, like what things we should include in our personas of our, like of our product and all?
So you can think it more like, okay, so if you have these kind of user, then probably flow should be probably this type. If you have probably other type of user, then what are the functionality you can provide? Or probably how the functionality you can provide. So it depends on who are all the target user that you have. Okay.
Sir, can you give sir little definition for the persona, because I a little bit confused.
Okay. Let me do a quick Google search in that case to show the best example, probably. So it's more about the personality, you can say. So in basically persona in the CI, I would search, right? So persona are the fictional character which you create based upon the research in order to represent the different user type that you might have, use at your service, product, site or brand, right? So one persona example you can think of, so for example, you have e-commerce website, right? So on the e-commerce website, one persona could be male, one persona could be female, one persona could be probably the kid or something else, right? Or probably one persona could be say, you're looking for formal clothes, something like that. Is it clear now? So persona is like a fictional character, which read based on your research in order to learn something, blah, blah, blah. So for more details, yeah, so please look at this link. Okay, so let's look at the two common representation, wheel and timeline. So like in this case, you have as a wheel, so how the user will experience, what all the user experience you are going to consider throughout the person use it. So for example, what user experience the person have before, during and after. So for example, what are the you need to do before, so like contact travel department, book tickets, receive tickets, check in at the probably some train station, and Heathrow express train to airport. So for example, before to go to airport, you need to follow this thing, right? So contact, book, receive, check in, and finally reach to the airport through the train. And what else? So even before the flight, you need to expedite the security, passport check, and probably waiting to the board into the comfortable launch. So this is all before you board. What is the during? So once you boarded the plane, safety procedure, takeoff, and probably sitting, sleep, if it is probably long journey. Some people like me, even in 1 hour journey, I sleep, right? So read, work, and quiet internet. So in case, I mean, there are some people want to watch during the time, some people want to work during the time. Choice of meal times, so like you don't want to get bothered probably at some time. You want to sleep. In order to deal this, how do the people propose solution? Like choice of meal type or probably sleep in fold out bed or something. Okay, so think more about it. So once probably, this is all the user experience we have during the, where all the user experience you can, because for example, during the board, the experience could be happy, bad. So safety procedure could be happy, bad. So these are all the aspects that you have in the user experience, and you want to increase or you want to improve upon all the user experience where even before, during or after. So for example, once you done your travel, then probably you short walked it in airport, pass immigration, luggage collection, and all those that you have. So these are the icons that you are looking at. So where the user icons are something you can think. So for example, custom fast check, how experience was that? So driver checks into the hotel for me, how was that? So accordingly, you can think of what all the functionality you are providing and when and where the user experience can be improved. So the last one is a representation using the wheel. The next is using the timeline. So here basically, suppose you want to achieve Megan deliver the presentation. So this is how the Megan can deliver the presentation, what all can happen in between during the, or probably before or after the Megan deliver the presentation. So steps would be Megan basically log on to the presentation system. Megan see the presenter page. Megan see that her slides are ready and she does a last minute flip through. Megan fixes an error and whatever the thing. And finally, Megan sees the audience members are starting to arrive. And this is the steps you can do and she can start presenting. But do we always have all those steps in the same sequence? It might be there something happens in between, right? So that's where some there's some question could be, there's some comment could be. So for example, here the Megan, the step is Megan log in to the presentation system. Should we let Megan log on if Iron hasn't set up everything? So you are expecting, because this has assumption, like the presentation system is already set up, right? So that she can log in and do. So that's why this question is valid. And the comment is Megan has already updated all the her slides and so on, or something like that. Similarly, Megan sees the presentation page, presenter page. So the presenter page should be reassure her that the streams and probably started and the preso is going to good and so on. So the presentation page should let her see that, let her see that email is there already, something like that. So accordingly, you can think of what are, when you are, because when you are basically presenting a whole experience map through the timeline, or be it like timeline or be it through the wheel, I mean, you can know that what all the things can happen at different steps. Once you know the different steps can happen, accordingly, you can do the appropriate steps, appropriate actions in order to help the user. So be it like improving the user experience. For example, there might be some steps where, so for example here. So Megan sees the presentation page. So here the one question could be, what if an audience member tries to connect before the Megan or even the before Ivan? So what will happen? So for example, similar thing you see in Zoom, right? So many times, our class starts at 11, right? But I see the emails or sometimes like, for example, Aditya has joined the class despite I'm not there. So what happened in that case? And what should happen in that case? Anyone? And what message do you see? At least the Zoom example that you have.
Aditya joined the meeting. The comment like, there's a comment in the bottom.
No, so that is comment I receive, right? But what Aditya will see? We are waiting for some host to start the meeting, something like that, right? Because despite you join the meeting, I mean, we cannot let you in the meeting until the host of the meeting allows you, right? Or at least the meeting has started. In that case, you will be put in the waiting queue, right? So even depend on the setting. You put in the basically the waiting queue because they only want the verified user to probably go in and probably attend the meeting, right? So in a way, I mean, you can visualize the.
Sir, you are not audible.
Can you hear me now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So I believe this is one of the another great example, right? So what if, I mean, your laptop exhausted all the battery, your laptop basically shut down, or so went to the sleep mode, right? So I think this should also be one of the steps and probably should have been considered, right? So for example, in fact, in order to deal with this, what they have done, so if you recall, usually the system give you some alert, right? Your system, your battery is low, you need to do something, you recharge. In fact, I got the message, but I forgot to turn on the switch actually. So that's how it happens. But anyways, I mean, this is one of the best examples you can, you just saw, right? So, okay, so let me share my screen again. Okay, so this is the timeline we are talking about. So we have also shown just example. So how you can construct basically the build and code prototype using electronics as well sometimes, especially in the physical computing. So are you aware of some of the toolkits which are listed here? So for example, Arduino, Lilypad, and all these. So have anyone used any of these? So if not, I mean, don't worry. I mean, you're going to use at least many of them, at least the Arduino you might be using in many of some of the courses at least. So in some of the design courses, in some of the, even the mobile computing course and probably some others, right?
Sir, what are they used for?
So Arduino is more like, you can say it's kind of the small devices which help you to accomplish something. So let me show probably example. I think that would be better.
Sir, Arduino too is a like a microprocessor, no?
Haha, exactly right. So that help this is. So Arduino is a kind of open source hardware and software company product, which basically single board microcontroller and so on. So through which you can issue different commands. So for example, if you recall one of our TA. Mank has built a game for visually impaired people, right? So if you recall, I mean, all the commands and everything, like, so what need to be done when probably when you see the vibration, when the person do some haptic activities, then what need to be done? Right? So often you can connect that through your mobile apps. You can connect that through probably other apps or probably the system that you're building. So this is the Arduino board we were referring to. So you have.
So what's the Arduino board do? Why we use that?
It's basically to design the control, right? To, for example, what will happen if I touch probably the third row? Let's refer to the blind visually impaired game we recall, right? So for example. You have a board where you have the list of switches, right? So based on that switches, if you touch some part, then what need to be done? You need to define, you need to code that part, right? Some actions need to be taken. So using this Arduino board, all these instructions are encoded. So you'll be get to know more about Arduino once you start using it. So I think if the course would have been probably offline because something this event you are missing. So many people have used Arduino in their course project, which probably is not feasible at the moment. But anyways, I mean, you'll get more opportunity to work with this.
So sir, can we use it in the game?
Haha, of course. Why not? People do.
For controlling, like for the, we made a game for a visually impaired person. So we use it.
Yeah. So similarly, I mean, these are some other devices that people do. So for example, just like, I mean, you can think of it, you have very small computer, right? The way you want to do something. So often these tools and things are available in form of SDK. SDK is the software development kit. So these are basically the programming tools and component to develop for a specific platform, for example, iOS or Android and so on. So include the ID, documentation, driver, sample code, or probably APIs, libraries, and so on. So it makes basically development, overall development, much easier. So similar thing, for example, available for Apple's, similarly for Amazon's Alexa, Microsoft Kinect, and even for Android SDK and so on. So the summary is, yeah.
So it is available for even for like open source platforms also. Like yeah, for yeah. example, if you, there is a for quantum computers, libraries like Qiskit or Circ has been built by companies so that people can code for their online on like cloud quantum computers also can work
yeah,
on.
Yeah. That's true. Okay, so yeah, so the summary is, yeah, so prototyping may be low fidelity such as paper-based, high fidelity such as software-based. Existing software and hardware basically helps create prototypes, just like through the libraries and probably the APIs they have. Two aspects to design, conceptual and the concrete. So in conceptual, it's more on the abstract level. In concrete, probably you be more specific and you can probably, you need to do some coding and something. Conceptual design develops an outline of what user can do and what concepts are needed to understand the product. Concrete design, specific design details, for example, layout or navigation to some code or so. And so three approaches to develop an initial conceptual model. We discuss about interface metaphor, interaction styles, and then interface styles. And we expand an initial conceptual model by considering whether product or user perform each functions, how these functions are related, and how the information, what information are required to support them. For example, we discuss about what data is required, how the data is being used, and so on. So once you generate the prototype for scenario and the use case, once it is ready, then physical computing kits, software development kits, etc., which are available, you can facilitate and probably use them to transition from design to the construction. So these the summary of this prototype and design. And
last, can you explain the last point? Physical computing kits.
No, I'm referring to physical computing kits like Arduino, right? We mentioned. So using Arduino or existing iOS or Android or probably this thing, right? Or all these, whatever the IDE SDKs which are available, you can use them to in order to complete the final construction, kind of final. For example, using Android SDK, you can build Android app. Using iOS SDK, you can build iOS app. Using Arduino, probably you can use some gaming app as you were referring, right? Does it make sense?
Yes, sir, but what's the SDKs mean? It's like a...
SDK is a kind of a generic term, which is the, you can say it's a kit. It's a kit. Basically, for example, you have toolkit, right? You have seen any toolkit, right? So where it has probably, it has a lot of things, like it may have hathoda, it may have probably the screwdriver, a number of things, right? In order to do something, you need a number of n things in order to build something, right? Similarly, in case of normal delivery development kit, now you have software development kit. So in order to develop a software, what are the different small items or probably the tools you require? So this is the kit of having all those tools. So that could be programming tools, that could be other components to develop some specific platform. So for example, iOS, or it could be some number. Is it clear now?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so any other question before we stop?
Yes, sir. We use all Arduino hardware software in only for gaming, or we can use in other?
No, you can use many ways. Yeah, I mean, it has so many, for example, use cases or projects.
It's basically just a small computer in itself. It can be used for anything.
Yeah, you can use in different ways. So even you can see Arduino music instrument, UNO fingerprinting, robot car. I mean, you can use so many ways here.
Okay, sir.
Yeah. Okay, sir. Any questions?
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah, Danish.
Sir, I have a request like regarding quiz. Like, can we in the Wednesday's quiz, can we have different two sections? Like in one, there will be a single correct and other there will be multi correct. So we can know that the answer is multi correct or single one, because it leads to a lot of confusion. So
that's fine. We want to create that confusion, because again, I repeat, what happened in mid-sem has disappointed me, and I want to make it fair to everyone, so that I don't want you to discuss. I want you to do by yourself. And that is the reason we have introduced this, and we don't want to change it. So in fact, this is for your good only, right? So just treat it that way. Just apply your thought. And again, it's fair for everyone, right? It's not only for you, it's for everyone.
So the next quiz was held on the Wednesday, no?
Yes, it is on the next Wednesday.
Okay.
Excuse me, sir?
Yes, Bhagesh.
So there was small request, sir. Like, sir, in section A also, sir, the project percentage was increased from 15% to 20%. So can, in our section also, can it be increased from 10% to 15% or 20%? Because what project is already taking a lot of.
So what is? No, I understand. I totally understand. So what is the weightage of project right now in the in the section A?
10%. 20%.
20%. So they have changed from 10% to 20%, right?
15% to 20%, like it was 15 earlier and then it was increased to 20.
It never been 15. It was 10 for both of us. They might have changed later. So earlier it was 10, right? Because we follow the same. Yeah, we follow the same policy, right? So it's not, but definitely we can change. So I mean, given that not all students are here, can you just do a plus one if you want to increase from 10 to 15? How many people I want to see?
But sir, what would be the cost? Like, where are we removing those marks from?
No, you don't need to remove, right?
Then we'll go to 109 out of exactly. Marks out of 109.
Yeah, so what's wrong? Because we do relative grading, right? We don't grade based on that. So it's perfectly fine. In fact, we do, right?
Can you poll on the classroom like you did once for tutorial activities?
Haan, sir, I think usse achha ho jayega. अच्छा सर, वन मोर थिंग अपार्ट फ्रॉम जस्ट दिस सर, वो जो मिड सेम हुआ था ना, आई नो काफ़ी टाइम हो गया मिड सेम को, बट उसके जो सोल्यूशन जो अपडेट होने थे ना आंसर की, वो कब आएगी?
आई हैव जस्ट कमेंटेड टुडे इटसेल्फ ऑन द गूगल क्लासरूम. आई टैग द बेसिकली द टीएस टू लुक इनटू दैट. सो आई विल आस्क देम पर्सनली एज वेल. अगेन
ठीक, थैंक यू सर.
ठीक है, सो व्हाट आई विल डू, आई विल पोस्ट अ पोल. सो आई टोटली एग्री एंड अंडरस्टैंड दैट प्रोजेक्ट रिक्वायर्स मच टाइम. And it should be, that's why, I mean, usually in my all courses, the project usually usually evaluated 40% of the overall. But since it's offline classes, online classes, that's why we have reduced from probably significant to 10. But yeah, definitely, I'm perfectly fine to increase from 10 to 20 or 15, whatever you guys are comfortable with.
No, sir.
It is a lot of effort, no, because we have to make that video prototype, report, presentation. So like, and that too in the last week itself we are doing it. So like, sir, it will be good to, you know, evaluate that also, because it is taking significant part of the week away, because we have IP assignment quizzes also in the last week.
Haan, I totally understand. Batao yaar, baki log kya karte ho?
Many of them are writing.
So let it be.
So the way I see it is that it's that much more difficult because of an online platform, and hence giving it more weight has resulted in more negative effect on us.
Teammates also.
It's much more difficult to coordinate with people.
So what I will do, I will post a poll on Google Classroom. If the majority would suggest that they want to increase, we can do. If it's more like 50-50, then we are not going to change. Okay.
And sir, there was one more request, like from many students, they were saying that many of their group members are not participating enough in projects.
So don't worry, sir, about that. No, so we already posted, right? We already posted that in the report. You have to clearly mention what is the individual contribution.
Huh.
If there is not equal contribution, and we are not going to give equal marks. So group project doesn't mean that बाकी यार लोग मजे करें, बस एक लोग आदमी काम करे, देन वी विल गिव इट फॉर मार्क्स. दैट इज नॉट गोइंग टू बी, सो डोंट वरी अबाउट दैट. And I believe the Kanupriya has already posted this, right?
Yes, sir. So
So actually, this thing decreases the efficiency for the project. Actually, like we would come up and to consume more time rather. If we actually before then 2 hour working, then actually it will consume more time for us.
Time to lagega hi hai na. It's a group project, right? So how you can leave everything on one person? Sabko equal time dena hai.
So can you extend the deadline?
I already extended the deadline. I think the deadline was 6, right? So now I increased to 10. Ab batao isse jyada aur kya improve kar do aur bada do batao. I mean, if everyone, so I can post, I can again, so I can make another poll, right? If majority of the thing, kyunki uske baad students ki complaint aati hai ki sir mera to plan hai exam ke baad, kyunki I cannot extend the deadline during the exam, right? Because you will be
plan out plan wo pehle kar dega.
Sorry,
जिसका प्लान है वो फिर पहले कर लेगा.
हाँ सर, एक्चुअली
हाँ सर, बात
सबका प्लान नहीं होगा ना.
I don't think that anyone would say no for that actually. So
चलो ठीक है. Again, so I can make another poll for this and yes. we'll see कि yeah, so Rakshit already mentioned, yeah, so पहले ये था कि यार पहले तो definitely I see a number of requests कि मैंने तो already कुल्लू मनाली जाने का प्लान कर लिया, जापान जाने का प्लान कर लिया, टिकट है तो वो रीजन नहीं है.
सेकंड वेव इज देयर.
हां सो
दैट्स आई नो सी द डेडलाइन एक्सटेंडेड डेडलाइन, दैट्स व्हाई आई टोल्ड यू टू एक्सटेंड इट. ओके
नहीं ठीक है, एक्सटेंड कर देंगे यार, दैट्स नॉट एन इशू.
नो नो
एक्चुअली वी आर इंटरेस्टेड इन डूइंग द वर्क, वी लाइक द प्रोजेक्ट का कांसेप्ट. अगर और टाइम रहे तो और मजा आएगा, दैट्स ऑल.
हाँ बिल्कुल यार, सो व्हाट वी कैन डू, वी कैन एक्सटेंड द डेडलाइन अगेन. सो वी विल टेक अ कॉल बेस्ड ऑन द मेजॉरिटी. इफ मेजॉरिटी थिंक्स इट्स डन, देन ओनली वी आर गोइंग टू चेंज और एक्सटेंड. इफ नॉट देन आई थिंक इट शुड बी
ओके.
मतलब सर लाइक प्रेशर
होगा सर, टीओटी होगा लंच के बाद.
क्या होगा? ट्यूटोरियल आज नहीं होगा ना, क्योंकि ट्यूटोरियल ऑलरेडी हो चुका है ट्यूसडे वेडनेसडे एंड सो ऑन.
यस सर,
यस सर.
So yeah, so I think it's good you highlighted that. We also need to make another post on that. So there is no tutorial today because we already done the tutorial earlier this week.
Sir, I had a question that if our project needs some surveys from the teachers, so can we send the teachers forms as well?
बिल्कुल यार भेज सकते हो, but depends on कि कौन कितना free है and so on. So keep the survey less, keep the survey the survey small, in a sense, I mean not more than 5 minutes. In that case you can make a request, so please do, it is required, and let's see.
So we can mail the teachers, right?
You can do, but there is no guarantee they will respond, right? Or probably
okay,
because since it's a end of semester, everyone is busy. So again, I cannot guarantee. So in a way, you need to think of, I mean, can you somehow convince, I mean, if you know someone from your probably other teacher who can help you with this.
Okay, sir.
Okay, anything else? Any other questions?
Sir, like for midsem, sir, like sir, in the normalization of the marks, like if there are like somebody is getting.
Bhavya, just give me a minute. I have a call. यार एक तो क्रेडिट कार्ड वालों को क्रेडिट कार्ड देना है, बट एनीवेज थैंक्स. सो या सुभागेस, यू आर आस्किंग समथिंग, प्लीज गो.
सो लाइक इन मिड सेम सर, लाइक इफ देयर इज सम लाइक समबडी इज गेटिंग लो बिकॉज़ ऑफ द मल्टी करेक्ट और समथिंग लाइक दैट, सो लाइक सर इज देयर एनी स्कोप फॉर लाइक हाउ कैन दे इंप्रूव द
क्वेश्चन
मार्क. नो नो, सो स्कोरिंग वी आर नॉट गोइंग टू चेंज. Because it's difficult. In that case, we need to change a lot of things. So only thing you can do.
I'm saying change. I'm saying that I was not able to understand like how are like somebody like I got around I think 17 marks in mid sem. So now I because of that 25% I will lose I think 4 point like more than the marks lost because each mark will cost 1.5%. Out of 25. So like how can I recover, like because I am not able to understand like if your project if total marks are 114 right now, sorry, 104 right now, so if that 4% is extra, so if I score all 114 marks, sorry, 104 marks, I will be getting a norm, like it, I will be able to cover it up.
So basically what Bhagesh is trying to say is, can we make the, let's say the tutorial ka 4 marks or bonus marks like IP sir has done? He has given us a question. So if you lose 5 marks somewhere else and you have done this question, we'll give you 5 marks for in place of that thing.
But so, like based more than on efforts, like they, in IP, they give us an extra question. So if somebody is able to solve that question, then they give bonus marks for it. Like they have introduced that concept for covering up, because there was some discrepancies like in questions. So they tried to cover it up using that.
But the current weightage is 100 marks only. It was 104 in the first place. But I think someone edited the comment in the classroom and it's currently stands at 100 only.
No, no. Like,
but it does not matter, na, like whether it's 100 or 104. Like
it's relative, na. वैसे क्या ही फर्क पड़ रहा है यार.
वैसे तो तो बात है कि देखो कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ता. ऐसा नहीं है कि अगर किसी को because we are going to follow the relative greedy, right? So for example, अगर maximum 104 marks भी आते हैं, that's fine. I mean, it's not a big deal.
Yeah, sir. That exactly.
Like and regarding bonus thing, I think. So that's why we are doing n minus 1 quiz, right? So at least theek hai wo midsem wale ke liye nahi hai, but at least you can do this for the whatever all the other quizzes we are doing, right? So that's why based on you guys request, we have implemented n plus 1 policy. Ye theek hai, out of 5 quiz we are going to only consider the 4 quiz, the best of 4. So if probably due to whatever the reason you could not get much marks in one of them, you can recover in the remaining.
So like अगर लोग प्रोजेक्ट की वेटेज नहीं बढ़वा दे तो कैन यू इंट्रोड्यूस दिस बोनस कॉन्सेप्ट लाइक बेस्ड ऑन द अमाउंट ऑफ थिंग्स समबडी इज पुट एफर्ट समबडी इज पुटिंग इन
भाग्यश ऐसे तो एवरीवेयर यू लूज मार्क्स यू विल वांट अ बोनस टू रिकवर देम
वो बट
24 घंटे एग्जाम ही देता रह जाएगा क्या
भाग्यश आई एम एक्चुअली इवन चीटेड इन मिड सेम सो इफ दे आर गेटिंग 20 सो आई एम नॉट सेइंग ना कि give them the negative marking for that.
Okay, so Bhagesh, let me think and probably discuss with other TAs as well. So bonus wala wahi hai ki agar kisi ko karna hai to kar le yaar. Let me see. So because you guys, only reason we did not add additional tasks because you guys are already may have very tight schedule, right? You may not have enough time.
Exactly,
अगर बोनस ही करवाते रहेंगे तो उस अकॉर्डिंग उसके अकॉर्डिंगली तो जब मतलब डीसी में तो हर जगह हमें बोनस चाहिए.
And sir, फिर तो अगर बोनस करवाते रहोगे तो फिर आप एंड में जो ब्रांच अपग्रेड के लिए कंपेयर करना कैसे ही करोगे? Everyone will get bonus and get
next question है भाई वो
that's not the problem, it's relative.
And also यार भागेश तो कोई चीज सजेस्ट करते ना पहले ग्रुप पे बात कर लिया कर.
नहीं it's fine यार there is nothing.
If I'm suggesting something, I'm not telling sir to take a decision on my suggestion.
So that's okay. We can discuss here.
I mean you guys can discuss with me anything, so it's fine. We are going to take a decision not only based on what Aditya, Sumit or Bhagesh or anyone is saying. We will take a call which probably will not affect everyone, but that's fine. So we can get started with whatever the you guys have given suggestion, we will consider. Whichever is feasible, we will do. If not feasible, we cannot do much. So
will the poll be uploaded today or itself?
Dal denge yaar aaj hi. Okay,
so email aa jayega yaar mujhe kar.
So please tell the name who is going to present today. Hello? Who is going to present today? Aaj koi nahi present kar
raha hai? Sir, presentation hai abhi.
Yeah, ye bhi ho sakta sir, khatam ho gaya wo presentation.
Kya pata sir, ab coffee pehle se chal rahi.
Acha, khatam ho gaya?
Maybe, I don't know.
जो बची जिंदगी है वीकेंड पे वो जी लो, जो निकल गया आप क्या कर सकते हैं।
इन्फॉर्मेशन ना जैसे आर्ट बोर्ड में ना कुछ इन्फॉर्मेशन डालने के लिए हम गूगल से कंटेंट उठा रहे हैं, तो फिर हमें गूगल सोर्स पे साइट करना होगा।
सबको साइट करो यार, जितने को जिसको साइट कर सकते हो। आई मीन इट्स नॉट कॉस्टिंग राइट,
मतलब वो रेसिपी का है कि रेसिपी जैसे एक खाने की बनाने की रेसिपी है तो वो गूगल से उठानी पड़ेगी इस खाने को कैसे बनाते हैं।
हां सो देयर माइट बी सम लिंक राइट जहां से तुम ये चीजें उठा, जस्ट
हां जी सर
साइट द लिंक।
ओके सर, साइट करने से मार्क्स तो नहीं घटते ना कोई?
नहीं नहीं, मार्क्स क्यों करेंगे, तो अच्छी चीज है, इट्स गुड प्रैक्टिस।
ठीक है सर,
अगर नहीं साइट करोगे तो माइनस मार्किंग हो सकती
है। नहीं नहीं सर, साइट कर देंगे। ओके थैंक
यू सर। लाइक वी हैव टू मेक अ स्पेसिफिक slide for the sources or sites we have used.
Haan, theek hai, chalo yaar, I'm getting an urgent call, so
okay sir.
Okay,
thank you sir. Bye.
Thank you sir.